Welcome to the Round the League podcast.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Round the League podcast. I'm your host, Bryant, and this is your podcast for everything sports. You can find this podcast on all of your favorite podcast platforms at the Round the League podcast and on YouTube at B-Man Films. So let's go ahead and get into it, starting off with NFL quarterback news. Alrighty, so starting off with a huge trade alert, the Philadelphia Eagles have agreed to trade quarterback Carson Wentz to the Indianapolis Colts for a 2021 third-round pick and a conditional 2022 second-round pick that will most likely turn into a first overall pick. For that to happen, Wentz will need to play at least 75% of the Colts' offensive snaps for the 2022 conditional pick to turn into a first-rounder, or it was something like 70% and the Colts make the playoffs. That seems very likely, especially since Carson Wentz is really looking like their quarterback. I'm almost 100% sure that they won't draft anyone, and as long as he doesn't get hurt, that is set up for the Eagles to get another for it to be a first and a third. So very exciting there. That's like a huge trade, especially with all the quarterbacks that are on the move this year, or that will most likely be on the move. I definitely think the Eagles kind of won this trade just by a small margin, getting a third round draft pick from this year and a first rounder most likely from next year. I think those will be key pieces since the Eagles are really trying to rebuild around either Jalen Hurts, or if they were to pick up another quarterback in this year's draft. I think a first rounder and a third rounder are going to be big. Trying to rebuild this team and trying to finish up this rebuild and get them into a playoff contending team. And Carson Wentz is kind of a question mark at this point. We've seen the really good Carson Wentz back from 2017, when he was going to be the MVP until he got hurt and the Eagles went to the Super Bowl and beat Tom Brady. And then in 2018, he was okay. 2019, he was okay. He was kind of okay, and then he showed some glimpses of being, like, a really great quarterback. And then he was just very subpar at the end of last year, him even getting benched for Carson Wentz for Jalen Hurts. So it'll be interesting. I think if Carson Wentz is able to play like he was in 2017 and even in 2018, where he was playing pretty good and showed some glimpses of being great, I definitely think that the Indianapolis Colts easily could have won that trade. But right now, the Eagles got the best out of that one. So exciting to see what Wentz will do with that. And with the completion of that trade, a crazy stat happens that is zero of the 22 quarterbacks drafted in the first round between 2009 and 2016 are with their original team after the Carson Wentz trade and the Matthew Stafford trade of this year. So that is pretty crazy. 22 quarterbacks that have moved. So anyway, I'm going to go through the teams that are most likely or have a good chance of being on the move this year. So the Arizona Cardinals and Kyler Murray are fine. Matt Ryan, there's a chance that he could be on the move or that the Falcons could draft a quarterback with their high pick this year. Baltimore Ravens are fine with Lamar. So are the Bills with Josh Allen. Teddy Bridgewater could be on the move or the Panthers could pick up another quarterback. Mitchell Trubisky has a good chance of being on the move with him getting traded away. Nick Foles being the starter or them picking up a new quarterback, and Nick Foles also has a pretty decent chance of being on the move if they either go with Mitch Trubisky or pick up a new starter or land one of the guys that I've talked about recently. The Bengals will be fine with Joe Burrow. Cleveland Browns will be fine with Baker. There's a chance that the Cowboys could trade or let go Dak Prescott. Dak Prescott, because he, after his ankle injury and he's costing a lot of money, they continue to franchise tag him. So it'll be interesting to see what happens there. Broncos are fine with Drew Locke. The Lions could possibly draft a quarterback to either sit behind Jared Goff or to play over Jared Goff. The Green Bay Packers, there's a small possibility that Aaron Rodgers could be on the move after saying that that him and a lot of other players' futures are up in the air. But I think he will end up staying with that team. Deshaun Watson, there's a good chance that he'll be on the move. The team has come out and said that they do not want to trade him. And that they're not going to trade him, but he's such a great talent on a team that he is obviously not getting along with, and on not a very great team. So hopefully they're able to turn something around. Hopefully they're able to turn something around, either getting to build a better team around Deshaun, or him goes to a better team that is willing to build around him. Aside from that, the Indianapolis Colts will be fine with Carson Wentz. The Jaguars' job is up in the air with them possibly trading Gardner Minshew or drafting. And there's a really good chance that they will draft a quarterback high with their first overall pick being Trevor Lawrence or Justin Fields. The Chiefs are fine with Patrick Mahomes, of course. Las Vegas Raiders, I believe they just traded away or let go Marcus Mariota, or are looking to. And who knows about Derek Carr? They could possibly draft another one. Justin Herbert will be fine with the Chargers. And the Rams will definitely be fine with Matt Stafford. There's a chance that the Tua job could, or that Tua could be a little bit up in the air. There's a chance that Tua could be a little bit up in the air depending on if they're willing to keep him. I don't think they saw what they wanted to out of him last year, but I really, really hope that he stays with that team, with the Dolphins, because they're a good team and they're really starting to build, and I think they're going to be a very good franchise come the next couple years. Oh, I'm not really sure about the Vikings and Kirk Cousins. I think they're going to keep him. But I'm not 100% sure. Cam Newton with the Patriots is in free agency. Drew Brees, who knows if he's going to come back. There's a chance that he could, because he has said that he would take a pay cut to stay. Daniel Jones is fine. Sam Darnold could be up in the air, and there's a really good chance that the Jets draft a quarterback or get Deshaun Watson. Eagles, who knows with Jalen Hurts. There's a chance that Jalen stays the Eagles starter. Because he's played pretty good so far, but they could pick up, they could draft another quarterback this year, since they do have a top 10 pick, I believe. Pittsburgh Steelers, they will have an open competition this year, between if they draft somebody, maybe Mason Rudolph, who will most likely not get it, Dwayne Haskins, who they picked up out of free agency, and Ben Roethlisberger, who might end up taking pay cuts to stay with the Steelers. The 49ers, I think Jimmy Garoppolo has that job, at least for now. He hasn't looked greatest over the past couple years, but he has battled a lot of injuries. Not exactly what they wanted from him after that big trade, not how well he played. Russell Wilson came out and said something about how he's getting sacked so much with the Seahawks for the second offseason in a row. So a lot of people jumped to conclusion very quick on that, and they were like, oh, no, he might get traded. But I personally think there's no way that he gets traded. The Buccaneers, they're safe with Tom Brady for now. I think he's going into free agency, so they'll have to re-sign him if they haven't already. But they will, but I'm pretty sure that they will re-sign him. And I would love, I think they have a last pick in the first round, a round where Mac Jones looks like he could go. I would love so much if Mac Jones could sit behind Tom Brady for 2 or 3 years, or 1 to 3 years, I'd say, and pick up some expertise from the greatest quarterback ever, like Jimmy Garoppolo did, and maybe he could carry on that Tampa Bay franchise that Tom Brady has really brought up out of the dirt. Ryan Tannehill will be fine with the Titans, and who knows with the Washington football team. Alex Smith had looked really good last year, but they could also draft somebody. So that's it from the quarterbacks. Now for a big move in the MLB, Now for a big move in the MLB, Fernando Tatis Jr., one of the great young shortstops in the MLB, just got a 14-year contract extension for $304 million. That is a lot of money in a long time. One of the longest contracts ever in MLB history. But aside from that, that is a huge move. I think it's a pretty good move for I think that's a pretty good move for the Padres. They just had a great offseason, signing some great pitchers like Yu Darvish, Trevor Bauer, and then just re-signing, Tatis there. Look for these Padres to be a great team. And it also begs the question, what would you pay some of the other great players in the MLB, like shortstop Xander Bogaerts, and Javier Baez, who are looking to be paid after this season, and even some non-shortstops like Aaron Judge, who is coming up on a big paycheck soon. So we could really look for these deals and what these players are getting to absolutely skyrocket, with some of the great, some of the good players getting upwards of $200-300 million. And now for spring training in the MLB, which will start February 28th at 1:05 p.m. with the Red Sox versus the Twins. And all on that day, 28 teams will be in action with 14 games. So only two teams will not play. That is my Chicago Cubs and one other team that I could not identify. So look for that to be an action-packed day on Sunday of next week. Very exciting that spring training is starting. Baseball is looking to have a normal season this year. But that's about it for the MLB. Now moving into some surprising football news. A couple teams are still going from earlier, around like December, and a couple teams have just started. As of today, I think. I'm not 100% sure on that. But a big game was Jackson State versus Edward Walters. This is where Deion Sanders went to coach. And he gets his first coaching win, 53-0. A huge win for Jackson State there. And a funny-ish story that just came out a couple minutes ago was that Jackson State coach Deion Sanders had come back to the locker room, and I guess his belongings had been stolen. So there you go. But aside from that, today that was the first game. So they were one of the teams that just started. Austin Peay lost 28-21 to 27 against Tennessee Tech. Youngstown State lost to North Dakota State 7-25. Mexico State is in the second quarter currently with Talleyrand State 30-7. So comment down below. I think I'll have that those enabled. They haven't been working, but comment down below if you want me to keep covering the FCS or you just find it boring. Nevertheless, there is football on, so that's that for the FCS. Now moving into the NBA. The NBA is closing in on the All-Star break, which will be Sunday, March 7th, in the games concluding Thursday, March 4th. And the games concluding Thursday, March 4th with the Kings and the Trailblazers. There's been a lot of debate over if they should or should not have the All-Star game, but for now, the All-Star game looks to happen in Atlanta. Despite some of the players being very against an All-Star game, the All-Star teams were announced on a card that still said that the game should happen on Sunday, March 7th, which is just around the corner, I believe 2 or 3 weeks. Now I will go over these teams. And now for the Western team, starting off with Captain LeBron James, then Stephen Curry, Nikola Jokic. I should know how to say that name, but I don't. Luka Doncic rounds out the Western. And for the East, starting out with Captain Kevin Durant from the Nets, then Giannis Antetokounmpo, Joel Embiid, Bradley Beal from the Wizards, and then also from the Brooklyn Nets, Kyrie Irving. So that's it for the All-Star game. As I've said before, I don't think that the 70th All-Star game should take place, but the league seems to have their heart set on it. I'm pretty sure that the league cannot force their players to play in it, so it would be interesting to see if some of these players end up like opting out of the All-Star game, or if they have to like opt out of the season. Say they opted out of the season and then opt back in when the All-Star break is over. I have no idea how that'll go, or if it will go, or if these players are going to end up playing, or what's going to happen. But for now, the All-Star game is set for March 7th. And now for college basketball, the regular season will end on March 8th with current number 21 Wisconsin playing number 11 Iowa. And then the conference championships will start in between March 4th at the earliest for WCC West Coast Conference maybe, all the way to March 14th. So all the conference championships will fall in between there. So look out for those. And then after that, we will start March Madness, which will be complete madness, in this season. It is, expected to happen all in Indianapolis, I believe. All of the teams, I guess, will be playing in Indianapolis, which will be interesting because I don't know how many, like, stadiums they're going to have, if it's going to be all around the city, all around the state. So it'll be interesting to see what the different teams are playing in. Will the teams be playing in Indianapolis colleges? Will they be playing where the Indianapolis Colts play? I have no clue how that'll go, but it should all be in one city, I believe, Indianapolis or Minneapolis. But aside from that, the season looks to wrap up with Gonzaga and Baylor still undefeated at 22-0 and 17-0. Michigan still has only one loss, 16-1. But that about wraps it up for this week's edition of the Around the League podcast. I really hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next week. Also, look for this to happen if you guys are still sticking around. YouTube just introduced this new thing called Shorts. So looking to kind of diversify and add some more content to my YouTube channel that kind of stays within the Around the League brand that I'm trying to build here. I'm kind of thinking about adding some breaking news shorts. So I'm just going to hop on there, set up some random place in my house or whatever. And I'm just going to film like a short. So they have to be over under 1 minute. And I'll just be like, so Carson Wentz just got traded. I'll be like, breaking news, Carson Wentz just got traded for this, 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 and this, courtesy of ESPN's Adam Schefter, I'll do something, like, similar to that. So look for that to happen, but that about wraps it up for this week's edition of the Around the League podcast. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next week.
Thanks for tuning in to the Around the League podcast. You can tune in next Sunday for another episode.